One of Jefferson's primary charges to Lewis was to carefully observe and document all plants and animals that the Corps would encounter. To do this, Lewis had trained in biology and had become quite a good scientific observer. He dutifully noted the details of any new species encountered and drew pictures of many of them in his journal. The Corps encountered many new species of plants, such as these rare bitterroot flowers and this prairie dog. They even were able to capture a prairie dog alive to send back to President Jefferson. Although far from being wild, Lewis's dog Seaman was the Corps' closest contact with the animal world throughout the trip. The Corps resorted to eating dog while on the Pacific coast. The local tribesmen could not understand why the Corps would trade for a dog to eat when they had a perfectly good large dog right in their midst. But many wildlife encounters were much more than scientific. The men depended upon bison such as this for much of their meat in the upper plains, or they ate almost exclusively elk like these while encamped at Fort Clatsop on the Pacific. Other wildlife posed great threats to the men. Rattlesnakes like this one under the rock were strong worries in many parts of the trip, and the spines of these prickly pear ripped at the moccasins of the men and tore their feet and legs brutally. On some parts of the trip, giant grizzly bears were almost a daily encounter. Lewis himself was almost killed by a charging grizzly. Sometimes the herds of bison were so massive that the men had to wait for hours for them to pass before they could continue on. As an observant and careful scientist, Lewis contributed strongly to the organized observation of wildlife in these new territories. Lewis was able to describe 178 species of plants and 122 animals that had never before been seen by science.